A very good morning to all of you. Welcome back to class 4 computer science, and today we are going to start the chapter 8, the last chapter of your book. Okay, we have skipped the chapter 7 because it is not a part of your syllabus. So we will begin with chapter 8, that is features of the file management. Okay, so before starting the chapter, we will like to discuss about what is file and the folder. As we have already studied the file, what is the difference between file and folder? The file is the work which you save when you perform any task or you do any work in any application software or any program. You use any program on the system, and when you use it, and when you save that particular job or a work on your system, a file is created. File is created which belongs to that particular application program. Okay, and in order to organize our files in a mannered way, we used to arrange the files into different categories. Like in your system, if you see, there will be different types of files will be there. Either it is a Word documents or PowerPoint files will be there, some games will be there, music files, images, photographs, musics, videos. Okay, so different types of files are there on your system. Okay, so we categorize all these files and we keep it in a such a way that it is easier for us that when we want to search that particular files, we can get to it easily. And in order to arrange or organize the files in a well-mannered way, we used to keep or separate them or categorize them into different categories, and with the help of the folders. The folders are generally the location on computer memory. The folders are generally the location on the computer memory where we keep our files into different categories. Like take example that we have created a folder with the name music. We have created the folder with the name music. Now, what we will do? We will keep all the music related files, all the files, either or any songs which are there available on your system or a desktop or a laptop. You can select them and you can keep it in that particular folder. In same way for the games, then pictures, all the photographs or images, whatever it is there on your system, you can select all of them and you can keep it in a separate folder. Then in the Word document, PowerPoint. So like this, you can arrange them into different categories, and the benefit of this is that it saves our time to find out. So suppose that you have not organized or you have not planned your files into proper way, and if you go on for searching for the files, then it will take a little bit more time. But if they are kept in a well mannered way and you know that the file which you are searching is of, suppose you are searching any game, okay, then you know that you are searching for a game, so you directly go to the game folder and from there you can search it up. So this is, in this way, the folders help us to organize. The folders are basically the memory locations. It is the memory locations which help us to arrange or to manage our files properly and in the well-planned manner. Okay, and the files are created when we save any job or a task which we have done on the computer. Whenever we save them, a file is created. Okay, so the files can be with of different application programs, and in same way the folders are of different. Now the folders can even contain folders. A folder can even contains folders and the files, and the folder which is saved inside the another folder, the folder which resides inside the another folder is known as some folder. It is known as the subfolders. And a folder can contain any number of files or folders within it. There is no limitations for that. That this particular file only contains this much files or folder. There is no limitations. You can keep any number of files or folders within there. Okay. So within this chapter, we will going to discuss about some of the topics related to how to arrange or how to organize our files and folders properly within our systems. And in this order, the first we will learn about. First, we will learn about how the files and the folders are created. Okay, how the files and folders are created. Then, how to rename the file. How to rename the file or folder. Clear? And then we will learn about how to copy and move the file. Copy and move the file and folder from one location to the another location. Again, there is a difference between copying the file and moving the file. I hope that you already know about that. What is the difference between copying the file and moving the file? Again, when we will go through this particular topic, I will explain you once again what is the major difference between this. Then we will learn about how to delete a file or folder from the system. How to delete it from the computer system. And then we will learn about some of the computer etiquettes, computer basic etiquettes, that is that we should not tamper, that is we should not interfere with someone other's, any other file or folder which you have not created. Okay, like suppose you now you can see that there are a lot of files and folders are there on my system, and if anyone get access to it, it is not good habit to just go on or make changes into these files or folders or to delete this file or folder, because it can be a work of any other person. Then, like I have given my so much time to create these files and folders for different purposes. Okay, and if someone comes and without my permission you are seeing it access to this particular system and they delete the files and folders, then it is not a good thing. So this is called a computer etiquette. We will learn more detail about this. So let us first of all begin with how to create a file or folder on the system. Okay, so as I told, when we do any work, when we perform any task or we do any work, a file is created on the system. Like suppose you use any application program, like here I have used Word. I am going to use the Word program. Okay, the Word application is opening, and here we will create one file. We will save it.
File. Okay, I have saved this file. Now you can see
this file as just we save the file which we opened in a Word program and we have saved it, a new file is being created on the system. So this is how the files are created. Whenever you save any work or a job which you perform on the computer, whenever it is saved, a file related to that particular task or work will be created on the system. Okay. Now we will learn about how to create a folder. So if you want to create a folder here on the desktop, what you can do is just right click your mouse, click the right button of your mouse, and as you click here you will get the new option. You will get the new option, and again in the context menu, when you will bring your mouse cursor near to the new option, you will click on this new option, you will get the different options like folders, shortcuts, and different application programs options are here also. So we choose a folder option from here. Folder option is here from here, and now you can see as we click on the folder option, the new folder is being created. A new folder is being created, and by default its name is given new folder. If you want to change the name, you can change. Like suppose I have given here the name file. Okay, so now you can see the file, and a file with name file has been created, and in same way we have created the another folder also. Okay, now if you want to open it, you can directly double click on this, and this is the folder, and it shows you this folder is empty. Another way to create is that suppose you have opened any folder or Windows Explorer is there, you have opened it, and you want to create a new file or folder. Here you want to create a new file or folder. So what you can do, on the menu tab, on the tabs, you can see the new folder option is given there. A new folder option is there, and as you click here, a new folder will be created, and just you have to specify the name. Like here, I have given the name ABC. So this is how you can easily create the new folders within the programs also. Okay, so this is how the new folder is again created. So these are the two different ways where you can easily create the folders. Clear? Now, how after creating the files or the folders, now how to rename the file or folder? Now suppose this was the file which we have created with name file, and if you afterwards if you want to rename or you want to change the name of this file, rename means to change the name given to that particular file or folder. So what to do in case of file, just you select the file whose name to which you want to rename. First of all you have to select the file. So we have selected this file, and then right click your mouse, click the right button of your mouse, and as you right click the mouse, you can see the context menu will open. The context menu opens, and from here at the bottom you will get the rename option. You will get the rename option, and as you click on the rename option, as you click on this rename option, the cursor changes and it starts making, and then you can easily change the name of the file like ABC, and then press the enter key, and now you can see that easily the name of the file has been changed from file to ABC. This is how you can rename any file easily. Okay, the another way or the shortcut for rename, if you do not want to use the mouse, is that first of all select the file. Suppose this was the file which we have created and renamed now with ABC. name ABC. What you have to do, just use your mouse and just select this file. Select this file and press the F2 key. Press the F2 key from your keyboard. The F2 key is the shortcut for renaming the files and folders. It is the shortcut for renaming. And as soon as you press the F2 key, the mouse cursor changes and then you can just type the name of the file. New. Like this. Now I have changed the name of the file to new. So this is how you can easily change the names of the files as you wish. As many times you want, you can easily change them and within some moment of time. Okay, the next one is how to change or rename the folders. How to change or rename the folder. Same thing, either you select the folder and press F2 key, select the folder and press the F2 key. So now see, I have changed new. Suppose this was the file. Here we have created one new folder. One folder is being created. Now, if you want to rename this file, you can just select this file and press the F2 key. The file name will be changed. ABC. Press the enter. The file name is then changed. Okay. In same way, if you do not know your by anyhow your format and the shortcut key for renaming, you can directly right click on the file, and you will get from the context menu, you will get the rename option. You will get the rename option, and from here also you can rename. Or the third option is, first of all, select the file and from the organize. Just about that, you can see the different tabs. Different tabs are there, and from the organize, you can just select the rename option is given. When you will click on the organize drop down arrow, you can get the rename option, and from here also you can rename well. So the new well. So this is how you can modify or make changes, or you can change the names of the files or the folders as much whenever you want. Okay. Now another thing is that how to delete the files or folders from the system. How to delete the file or folder? Now suppose in example that this was the file we have created, the new file which we have created. If you want to delete it, either you can just select the file and you press the delete button from your keyboard. Just to press the delete button, and you can see a delete file dialog box opens. Delete file dialog box opens, and it will ask you, are you sure want to move this file to the recycle bin? That is, whether are you sure that you want to delete this particular file? If yes, if you click on the yes, the file will be removed from here and it will be moved to the recycle bin. Recycle bin, as all of you know, what is the use of the recycle bin? It is just as a dustbin where all the deleted files are being placed. And so suppose I have clicked in, yes. Now you can see the new file has been removed from here, and if we change the recycle bin, now you can see the same file is appearing here. Now suppose that by mistake if you have deleted this file. Now suppose that you took more than 2 or 3 days to create this particular file, and by mistake if you anyhow you have deleted this file, what you can do, that it is placed in the recycle bin. So what you can do, you can this item. And or if you want to delete it permanently from your system, then you can choose to empty the recycle bin. You can choose the another option, that is empty the recycle bin, or you can delete it from the recycle bin also. Suppose here I select restore this item. So as soon as I click on restore this item, the particular file has been removed from recycle bin, and again it appears on my desktop. That is, this file has been not deleted. Another option to delete the file is that you select the file and you press the shift plus delete. Press the shift plus delete, and again it will a dialog delete file option will appear, and once you click on this yes, once you click on this, what will happen that it will, now you can see the difference between these two commands. Once earlier one we used only delete key, earlier one only we used the delete key, and when the delete file dialog box opens, it was giving the message, are you sure you want to move to the recycle bin? And when we use shift plus delete key, it is asked, are you sure you want to permanently delete this? That is, the file will be permanently deleted from the computer system, and afterward also, if you want it, you can't get back to that particular file. It will be permanent, it will not go to the recycle bin. Will be deleted permanently. So you clear here, yes, and you can see the file has been removed from the desktop and it is not appearing within the recycle bin also. So these are the two difference between, or the another option to delete is that to delete is either you can just right click on this. Right click on the file and you can select the delete option. You can select the delete option, again the delete file. Are you sure you want to move the file to the recycle bin? The file is being removed. Okay, in same way, if you do for the folders, we have opened the folder. This is the folder we have opened, and we have created one folder here. And if you want to delete this file, either you can go to the organizer. Click on the organize and select the delete option. You select the delete option, it will ask for the confirmation message. Yes or no, I have selected here, no. Another way to delete is select the folder and right click here, you will get the delete option within the context menu. Or another way, either you press the delete key from the keyboard, or you permanently want to delete it, then shift plus delete. It will be deleted permanently. So now you can see this folder is empty. So this is how we can delete the files or folders within our system. Okay. In the next class when we will meet, we will learn how to copy or paste the file, or what is the difference between copying the file and moving the files. Okay, so till that time, thank you and have a very nice day.